Hi there friends, welcome back to the channel. In today's episode, I'm going to discuss opportunities within power systems industry as a design engineer. Electrical design engineering can take different shapes and forms. I have spent majority of my career as a practicing engineer in design engineering, in the MEP environment, in engineering consultancy, EPCM, and then as an owner's engineer. Now to be fair, design engineering is a very broad term. It encompasses all aspects of electrical engineering. And if you're talking about power systems, you can broadly classify into low voltage, medium voltage, and high voltage. Each one of them is a world in itself. So let us start with low voltage power system design. As an end user, as a consumer of electricity, this is the slice of power systems engineering that we are most often exposed to. Whether we are looking at it from a residential standpoint, commercial standpoint, in our offices, schools, hospitals, shopping centers, parks, cinemas, restaurants, everywhere. Typically, low voltage is classified as anything less than 1000 volt. So what are some of the opportunities that exist for electrical engineers with a focus on power systems engineering in this space? As a design engineer, you can be working directly for an MEP firm, for an EPCM, a consulting firm. We can classify all of them as engineering design firms. Typically, most of the engineering design firms are multidisciplinary, which basically means that you are not going to be working in silo. As an electrical engineer who's working on the power systems design for low voltage distribution, you're most likely working with a lot of other disciplines. If you're talking about a residential and a commercial setup, then more often than not, you'll be working with architects. They'll be responsible for the general layout of the building, school, restaurant, housing community, hospitals, shopping malls, and so on. In this space, you will primarily be doing design work that will be associated with receptacle layouts, wiring, distribution panels, small transformers, which are primarily distribution, dry type transformers, lighting transformers, less than 100 kVA. You'll also be doing raceway designs, conduit layouts, a little bit of power system studies, interacting with the utility for service entrance power supply, and coordinating with architects for placement of electrical equipment, loading requirements, coordinating with HVAC engineers, mechanical engineers, lighting design, lighting controls, and specifying small electrical equipment, as I mentioned, transformers, lighting panels, receptacles, deciding upon the cables, their sizes, types of lighting fixtures, and so on. There's a decent amount of growth in the residential and commercial space. You will be required to use NEC very frequently. Once you do a few of these projects, you're gonna find things becoming repetitive. There's nothing wrong with getting good in a particular specialization, but generally speaking, if you have been working in the residential and commercial space, within 5 years, maybe maximum of 8 years, you will find the type of projects, your skill set, and your growth sort of plateauing. You can always push the envelope by taking different roles within this space. You can start providing field support, participate in commissioning and startup, although the commissioning and startup that you're going to do for electrical equipment is going to be fairly small because the nature of loads is very small. You can get really good with compliance, interacting with authority having jurisdiction, your local electrical body. You can also start taking leadership roles in terms of bidding on different projects. After you've done a few of these projects, you can get into leadership role, the number of hours that will be required for carrying out a project. And I've seen some of my students in this space, when they go through my FE Electrical and PE Power exam preparation programs, they become licensed engineers when they have enough experience under their belt. Some of the students actually start their own consulting firms, which can be very lucrative, especially if you have connections in the industry and good reputation. And as I mentioned in the beginning, there's steady growth in this space because of the increasing population and a continuous demand and expansion on the residential and commercial front. If you decide to specialize in electrical design engineer on the residential and commercial side of things under low voltage, my recommendation to you would be to try and get as many challenging projects as you can as quickly as possible. The initial learning curve, especially if you're right out of school, may be a little bit steep. But once you complete a handful of these projects, ideally under mentorship of a seasoned electrical engineer, then you'll be able to accumulate those hard skills that are very portable and can be carried over to other aspects of electrical design engineering, even into medium voltage and high voltage. I hope you found this video helpful, and I'll be discussing medium voltage and high voltage design engineering in my next videos. Please let me know your thoughts, suggestions, and any comments in the comment section of this video. Thanks again for watching. I'll see you in the next episode. If you like this video, then please don't forget to subscribe to this channel. Feel free to ask me any questions in the comment section of this video below. You can find tons of success stories of my FE Electrical and PE Power students over here. And if you want to learn more about preparation of FE Electrical and Computer exam and the P Power exam, then check out these playlists over here. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you soon in the next video.